Hello and welcome to Titanfall! Silreis here with the first guide for the game, and this one is going to be about the triple threat weapon. This is an interesting weapon to start the whole weapon guide series with, I believe. And frankly, I don't want to talk about stats, like how many milliseconds it takes to reload and so on. I want to talk about the actual gameplay with the weapon. So triple threat fires three bouncy balls, which home in on armored targets, essentially other titans, as in hostile titans. However, note that you can absolutely damage yourself with the explosions of this weapon. Which means to be a little careful where you shoot them and don't stand in the explosions yourself. The weapon doesn't have massive range, so you have to get quite close to a target to actually fire it. And the alternate fire mode with it turns the horizontal into vertical, so it fires them three underneath each other. And they are timed, so if you fire them high into the air, they will explode in the air without actually touching the ground. The triple threat simply does not have the sustained damage capabilities of, for example, the XO-16 chain gun. That thing is an absolute monster if you can pour your entire magazine into a single target without interruptions. This thing, however, triple threat, it is pretty good for assassinating single targets. Because you can unload the 9 or 12, if you are using extended magazines, shots, well, balls of explosion into a target rather rapidly and then back off to reload. And the damages are pretty good. This is not a weapon, however, for killing infantry, because infantry can, pilots especially, can easily avoid this stuff. AI, as in the NPC randomly running around, those probably cannot. However, pilots can double jump, and they are above the explosion when the explosion happens and they do not get damage. And they can easily hide in buildings or behind walls or whatever, because they are timed explosives. It takes a moment before they explode. But for single Titan, this weapon is absolutely able to demolish them. And since it is ballistic weapon, you can shoot them from relative safety. You can shoot it over buildings, over boxes and whatnot. From places where anyone with a direct fire weapon, such as the 40mm or the chain gun, cannot retaliate. So take advantage of positions like that with this weapon. And note that this is a good weapon if you want to equalize amount of titans on both sides. Such as, for example, your team only has 2 titans and their team has 4. Something like this. You can suicide yourself, basically trade one of your titan for an enemy titan with this weapon really easily if it comes to that sort of a situation. Let's talk some loadout suggestions then. Ordnance first. I would personally suggest using cluster missile with this thing. That's because the gun itself is already pretty good at dealing with other titans, but, well, aside the fact that you have to get pretty close to the said titan to actually be able to hit it. But if we take that out of the equation, you have no way of dealing with infantry. Especially infantry hiding inside buildings, like many pilots like to do when there are titans around. And firing cluster missile inside of a building, or into a building through a window or a doorway or whatnot, usually clears the building rather efficiently. And if you get really good with it, you can hit pilots in midair with a straight-up shot with cluster missile and kill them in a single hit. That is my preference for it. You could argue for slaved warheads as well, to be able to lock onto other titans and have absolute monstrosity of the time of dealing with the other titans. That could be workable, very workable as well. I tried it out a few times. I didn't find it as useful as the cluster missile though. As for your tactical ability, I would personally suggest using the electric smoke. It is simply overly useful for a variety of situations. Even if we discount the whole, you know, being able to get pilots off your back, such as popping a smoke, packing out of it and firing your own grenades into the smoke so that the advancing enemy titans run blindly into explosions. That sort of little tricks and whatnot, the smoke is simply useful. The vortex shield can be obviously a good defensive tool. I wouldn't suggest using it with this weapon though, unless you absolutely feel like you want to use that thing. Because if you interrupt your firing to use vortex shield, you are on the defensive, which can obviously save your life, but it means that you have typically fired a round or two and then you vortex shield, you might only have three to basically one or two shots before you have to reload anyway. So smoke does not prevent you from reloading or firing. There is that. And be really, really careful if you want to use force field, because the bouncy balls of death do not explode on contact with the force field. That means that if you set up your own force field, you might be shooting at it and bouncing the balls back onto yourself and damaging yourself with the explosions, as in the balls keep bouncing away from the force fields. Now, let's talk quickly about what to do if you are facing anyone using this particular weapon. First things first, get into a range they are uncomfortable with. Either you stay outside of their firing range, just as using the 40mm or plasma railgun or whatever, or even the chain gun from extreme range, so you are outside of their range of fire, or if that's not possible, get in their face, basically melee range. Because if they are firing these bouncy balls of death into you at melee range, they are also damaging themselves. And even though you might die for the process, in the process, you probably will take them with you because they are dealing damage to themselves too with the explosions. So there is that. And finally, let's just touch briefly on the attachments for the triple threat. Those attachments being either minefield or extended mags. There is really no reason whatsoever to use the minefield. Without extended mags, you only have 3 shots, which is frankly not enough to kill a titan, even if you hit all 9 of them. With extended mags, you have 12 rounds, as in you can fire 4 times and that's 12 of the bouncy balls of death, and that is typically enough to get rid of a strider, and typically also a slightly damaged Atlas is entirely gone. Now that is good by itself, but it also means they are going extended mags, that is magazines, not mags. Anyway, going that route also means that you are able to do better sustained damage, because you can fire 4 times instead of 3 between reloads. So people might not catch you off guard and you might actually be able to survive one-on-one encounters against someone using, for example, the 40mm or whatnot. Or might really scare them away since they notice that they are taking insane amounts of damage all of a sudden. The minefield, like I said, is simply not as useful as the extended mags for a weapon where going from 3 to 4 shots is a massive deal. Thank you very much for watching, hopefully you found this guide helpful, and there will be more Titanfall weapon guides coming out pretty soon.